Okay, it's April 3rd, 2022. It's a Sunday. It's the second day of my spring break. I just got in the car with Justice. We finished packing and getting everything ready because we are going on a road trip to Lake Tahoe. I have a rough itinerary. I'm staying the night tonight at my relative's house in Southern Oregon. Right now I'm in Southern Washington, so I'm gonna drive the whole length of Oregon today. My main goals for this trip are I want to do some new things, some touristy, iconic things, and just meet new people. This is the first big trip I've taken without my mom. We usually did our spring breaks together because she was also a teacher, but I don't have her anymore, so she's with me in spirit, and I'm going to do this in honor of her. Let's go!
I'm sunny side and over easy, 100 miles from Alameda, stopping by and taking in the view.
First stop of the trip, we are at a cute little rest area somewhere east of Eugene. We have 3 hours and 23 minutes until we get to my relative's house. They actually live at a ranch, so I'm going to a ranch.
Who loves a good goodbye and a good hello? I'm just a tourist. I don't know where I belong and might sound foolish. Yeah, but nowhere feels like home. So I roam from town to town, taking snapshots of the world.
Over a tree, and I drove through a bunch of snow.
You're gonna be in my video.
Oh no! I'm really not photogenic.
No, it's okay.
I'm a guitar case in a denim jacket. If I don't need it, I don't pack it. Mama always told me travel light.
Okay, good morning. It's day two, and look, it's snowing. So after breakfast this morning, we packed up and we hit the road. So it's about 10 a.m. right now, hoping to get to Tahoe by 5 or 6. Fingers crossed. All right, we'll see you later.
I'll sit a spell, but I won't hang around, 'cause I'm just a tourist. I don't know.
Okay, I made it to California a couple hours ago, and it's super windy. We are 2 hours from Tahoe. So we got a little bit farther to go. We're gonna get to Reno, and then just a little ways after that, we'll be in Tahoe.
Local bar, a world, and I wanna see it all, so I keep moving. I'm just a tourist. I'll take a couple memories, but I won't stay behind. Cause I'm just a tourist. I don't know where I belong and might sound foolish. Yeah, but nowhere feels like home. So I roam from town to town.
So I'm just gonna recap what happened today. I made it to my little Airbnb. I do have a kind of a sketchy neighbor who keeps like running back and forth on the deck outside. Tomorrow, my plan is to maybe go on a helicopter ride, just do some sightseeing, maybe get breakfast, coffee. So I feel like I'm in a good place. I just feel very proud of myself for doing this. And yeah, I just feel like I'm being taken care of in an odd way. Good morning! It is day three. This is our first full day in Tahoe. We are still in South Lake Tahoe, checking out of the Airbnb.
When it's not always raining, there'll be days like this. When there's no one complaining, there'll be days like this. Everything falls into place like the flick of a switch. Well, my mama told me There'll be days like this.
I just got done with my helicopter ride, and it was so fun. And my pilot was really nice. He told me a lot of fun facts about the area, some history, and gave me some suggestions on what to do while I'm here. And side note, everyone I meet here is just, like, really friendly and wants to tell me all about, like, different activities I can do. Yeah, it's been good. So I just picked up some lunch, and now I'm going to this place called The Hangar.
When you don't need to worry, there'll be days like this. When no one's in a hurry, there'll be days like this. When you don't get betrayed by that old Judas kiss. Oh, my mama told me there'll be days like this. When you don't need an answer, there'll be days like this.
Okay, hi. I'm in my new little Airbnb for the next 3 nights, which is exciting because I really like it here. So after lunch, Justice and I started driving up to the north side of the lake, which is where we are now. And on the way here, we stopped at the Emerald Bay State Park and went on a little hike. I just wanted to say that I'm having a really great day and just a great trip overall. I just feel like everything's going my way. It's just great. The people are great, the scenery, all the activities that I'm doing. Like, this is like my ideal vacation.
Days like this. When everyone is up front and they're not playing tricks. When you don't have no freeloaders out to get their kicks. Well, that's nobody's business, the way that you want to live. I just have to remember there'll be days like this.
Good morning. It's day 4. We are going snowshoeing this morning. And it's really nice outside. Like, I feel like I'm gonna be too hot. But no, it's been good so far. Today, we went on a little walk to a coffee shop. And then afterwards, Justice played in the water and met a new dog friend. And I talked to some more people, because that's just what I do. After we go snowshoeing, maybe we'll go paddling. We'll see. Okay, bye.
Hey, I'm Farmer, and today we're gonna do a snowshoe experience in the Grand Sierra Nevada Mountains.
Oh, my mama told me there'll be days like this. Oh, my mama told me there'll be days like this. Oh, my mama told me there'll be days like this. Oh, my mama told me there'll be days like this.
Justice and I just got back from our morning/afternoon adventure, and I took a shower because I was feeling pretty sweaty. We started off doing the snowshoeing hike, and we met our guide, and he had a really southern accent, which was endearing. He really just loves Lake Tahoe, and he loves to share his love for it with people he meets. We walked through the snow for about a half hour, and then we stopped and sat on these big rocks and just fed the chickadees. And after that, we went straight to Sand Harbor. We paddled for like an hour and a half at least, like a long ways. It's been a really, really good day, going along with the trend of the trip. All right, we're gonna go get food. We're hungry.
Oh, my mama told me there'll be days like this. Oh, my mama told me there'll be days like this.
Good morning. It's day 5? I don't even know. But it's my 3rd full day in Tahoe and my last full day in Tahoe. Getting kind of sad, but I'm really excited for today. And this is the first day where I haven't had anything like on the agenda where I have to meet with anyone. So it's just Justice and me. And my plan is to go paddling for most of the day and eat good food.
Don't listen to the voice inside your head. You're doing just fine, you're trying your best. And no one ever told you it's all gonna be okay. When you lose faith in everything you ever knew, don't give up on you. When life gets overwhelming, relying on yourself is hard to do.
give up on you, no. If you've been lost and lonely, ashamed to be alone with only you, with no one left to lose, if it's the last thing that you do, don't give up on you. Living off opinions for way too long, afraid to be right, ashamed to be wrong. If no one ever told you it's all gonna be okay, those people always keeping up to keep you down.
Hi, we've had a great day today. Got breakfast and then we paddled about 6 miles down at Patton Beach, and then we went and I got some iced coffee and then we got some pizza. So it was a really good day, and now we're watching the sunset.
Life gets overwhelming. Relying on yourself is hard to do, but don't give up on you. No.
If you good morning. It is day 6. And we are leaving Lake Tahoe today. Sadly, but also not sadly, because it's been such an amazing trip, as I've said about 100 times before. And we are going to a place called Tunnel Creek Cafe. And then I'm gonna try to check out this little place called Hidden Beach. And then we're gonna be off to Carson City to walk with goats. So stay tuned.
Those people always keeping up to keep you down. Stop looking for a reason just to keep them around. I know they never told you it's all gonna be okay. Lose faith in everything you ever knew. Don't give up on.
So I'm about an hour and a half north of Carson City right now. Oh boy, but I'm like finally like, whew, I'm finally calming down from, I had like such a busy day. First of all, we went to the Tunnel Creek Cafe, and then I noticed a sign that said Monkey Rock this way. And I was like, Monkey Rock? What is that? But it piqued my interest. So what I did is I ran down this path to a little beach called Hidden Beach, which is what I was planning to do anyway. And that on its own was the most heavenly beach I've ever seen in my life. And I had it in my mind. I was like, I want to go see Monkey Rock. So on the way back to the car, I ran up the side of a mountain to go see Monkey Rock. It was so steep, and I got there and I was just like out of breath, but it was just a happy monkey looking out, you know, over the lake. And I texted the goat lady and I was like, we're gonna be a little bit late, like 10 minutes late, but we're coming.
Don't give up on you, no. If you've been lost and lonely, ashamed to be alone with the only you.
Oh, these goats were so cute, and they all had names and name tags, but there was one that was like kind of reminded me of a dog, and its name was Sharky, and it had like floppy ears.
Hi, Sharky.
And we walked back and I talked to the lady. She had lived in Carson City her whole life and was just a really interesting person. But now we're heading to Ashland. We're gonna stay in a hotel, be fancy.
Yeah. When life gets overwhelming, relying on yourself is hard to do. But don't give up on you, no. If you've been lost and lonely, ashamed to be.
Good morning, it's day 7. We made it to Ashland. Justice is slopping up some water. It's been a really great trip. I've just been sitting here just reminiscing about how wonderful everything has been. So today we are headed home. We're gonna explore Ashland just a little bit and then start driving back.
Don't give up on.
Okay, we are done with our trip. We just pulled up to my apartment. Oh, I cannot believe what a wonderful trip that was. And I was just looking back at my footage that I made on the first day, and I said that my goals were to do something new and something iconic and to meet people. And I did all of those things. I felt like a tourist in many ways, but I also did things that the locals did too. And I really got to know people and just hear their stories. Like, as I was meeting these people in Tahoe, like, they were just so welcoming, and they like taught me so much about like what's important in life. And I do think that's like God working through people to like show me how much God loves me. Like, it was just like, it was just grace. Like, I didn't deserve it. And I don't know, I don't know how to describe, like, I'm getting emotional. This is really dumb. But on the last day that I was in Tahoe yesterday, Justice and I went to Hidden Beach. At Hidden Beach, when I looked out onto the water, I was just like, this is how the Bible describes heaven, with like the sea. It just looked like glass. I mean, it was a lake, but it just had this like light, majestic feel to it. I just thought about my mom, and it was just a good reminder of like that there is hope in this life. So yeah, if you're in a funk and you just want to like be refreshed, you can do one of two things, or you can do both things. First thing is adopt a middle-aged dog who you know is loyal and well-behaved, because you will realize what unconditional love is through that dog. The second thing you can do is go somewhere new, somewhere that has either like a rich history or rich culture, and just talk to people. Go there and just start talking and asking them why they love living where they live. And also, don't expect everything to go perfectly like it did with me. And I fully understand that maybe the next trip I do, something terrible will happen. But I'm just savoring this trip and remembering what grace is, because I definitely experienced grace on this trip. So yeah, that's all. Woo. Oh my gosh, I'm okay. Okay, bye.